Lokpal politics is back. Yet that doesn't mean we will finally see a bill passed in the session. The government said today it will bring the bill afresh to the Rajya Sabha as a completely new bill towards the end of April. The BJP says this is a delaying tactic and will disrupt question hour tomorrow to ask that the debate must begin immediately.
The session must take off from where it ended last time.
In the session, certainly. In the session. I can't say about the first part.
The last session ended on a terrible note. When the government, in order to avoid a vote in the Rajya Sabha on the amendments to the Lokpal Bill, disturbed the session and had it adjourned.
Since there were large number of amendments earlier, a situation developed where under we could not take it up further that day.
Since they wanted time to consider those amendments, I'm sure they've had more than sufficient time.
So we have to study what are the amendments there. Government has to form a view and then we'll come up with those to the House.
So as the Lokpal war begins again in Parliament, I spoke a short while ago this evening to one of the key campaigners for the Jan Lokpal Bill, very different to the one that is in Parliament, Arvind Kejriwal. Arvind Kejriwal has all the politician bashing by Team Anna and the campaign for the Jan Lokpal Bill actually been negated by what happened in these elections and the huge voter turnouts. A record victory for Mulayam Singh Yadav, whom Team Anna had actually targeted for corruption charges against him.
You see, I don't know how you would... I would analyze the entire thing as a strong mandate against Congress. I don't think it's a strong wave in favor of any particular party, because that party has not done anything. In 2007, the people threw out this party. And sure. 2012, there would be a strong wave in favor of this party. What happened in these 5 years? Nothing happened in these five
but
years.
But in UP, do
so
you
I
see
think
this
large voter turnout...
But in UP, do you see it more of as an anti-BSP wave than the Congress? What do you actually see as the wave in UP?
Right. So three things happened. At a national scale, there was a strong mandate against Congress, because what Congress did at national level against Anna Hazare's movement and against Baba Ramdev's movement. So the people were watching it, and at every stage they cheated the people of this country and they also tried to crush the movements. Second thing, at local level, there was an anti-incumbency factor. And in my opinion, the anti-Congress thing was far more stronger than that, which got reflected in both Punjab and Uttar Pradesh.
Right,
but since in Uttar Pradesh it was a four-cornered...
No, but Arvind Kejriwal, in Hisar, in that by-election, if you remember, you had said that your campaign, and you had campaigned extensively, actually influenced the result of that election. But in the UP and Punjab elections, Anna Hazare and you didn't campaign. Do you think the Anna campaign against corruption was actually irrelevant in this election, that in fact the people with the high voter turnout actually rejected Team Anna?
You see, there are the two campaigns were completely different. In Hisar campaign, it was against Congress, because at that time we wanted to show that the people who came on the streets, the people who came to Ramlila Maidan, were not just participating in a movement, they could actually get converted into votes also. And it was amply demonstrated, because the manner in which Congress was defeated in Hisar, it amply demonstrated them. We thought that because of that, Congress would be pressurized into bringing a good Lokpal bill, but they did not. And what happened in December was amply clear that most of the parties were not in favor of a Lokpal bill, a strong Lokpal bill. So therefore, after December, all of us sat together and we decided that it was not right to campaign against any one political party. And therefore, the campaign post-December in these five states was not against a political party. If you have seen the campaign, we never said that this party's... We presented every party's role in Jan Lokpal movement and in December debates, and we left the choice to the people. But the people themselves were watching what was happening in the last 1 year.
Right, but Arvind Kejriwal, you've been campaigning for the Jan Lokpal bill. You're in Mandi currently doing that. But we've seen again now, the government has said that they will only bring this bill again in the Rajya Sabha towards the end of April. The BJP says they want it sooner. But are you convinced, given what you said about all political parties, that we will actually see a Lokpal bill pass this session, or will it be like the women's bill?
We hope they will take lesson from what happened in these elections in these five states. we hope that they will withdraw this bad and dangerous Lokpal bill, which would increase corruption rather than reducing. And we hope that they will present a good Lokpal bill and get it passed as soon as possible.
But Arvind Kejriwal, can you actually link what happened in the elections with the Jan Lokpal bill? Because, for instance, Akhilesh Yadav, as I said, you targeted Mulayam Singh for corruption. Sukhbir Badal, the Badals have had charges of corruption against them. In fact, in Uttarakhand, where you said the BJP government had passed an ideal Jan Lokpal bill, the BJP government actually lost. Was corruption really an issue, or your version of the Jan Lokpal bill an issue, or was it development which is the issue in these elections?
Did the voters have a choice? In your opinion, out of the four parties which were there in Uttar Pradesh, so people have no choice. So people only have a choice in this country to throw out parties. But when it is bringing someone to power, the people have absolutely no choice. So sometimes when you draw conclusions in media that if there are 35% criminals, they were voted by the people to power, but the people had no choices.
The NDTV News app had redefined the entire genre. Now, another market beater. It's already hit number one.
NDTV Profit, India's number one finance app. Download free at ndtvprofit.com/apps. Live stream of NDTV Profit, market news, and your easy-to-manage portfolio. Download now, ndtvprofit.com/apps.